So today I thought I'd demonstrate a few walking practices that we can think about doing ourselves as well as sharing with the kids whom we're working with. So we can start by just taking a look at this quick sketch that some of you may be Monty Python fans or some of your kids are Monty Python fans, and this is a good kind of warm-up introduction.
Time, please.
Oh, yes, I have.
Thank God.
Yeah.
I can never get enough of watching Monty Python. That's one of my favorite sketches and an absolute classic. But someone was pointing out that really when we make ourselves walk in a really silly way, that actually forces us to pay a ton of attention to what it's like to actually walk. We have to really be aware of each movement that we're making as we're super silly in some ways, and just being noticing each movement and having to keep our balance and swinging our arms and just being incredibly, incredibly silly, even with each walk, it requires all this careful movement and really thinking it through. And so one of the fun exercises we can do with that is to do, starting out just with regular walking, just allowing yourself to walk back and forth. And we might say, make you walk just a little bit silly. How about like 10% silly? And then maybe like a quarter silly, 25% silly. And then like 50% silly. Then 75% silly. And 100% silly. And then maybe back to 90% silly. 75% silly. And then 50% silly. And 25% silly. And just 10% silly. And just back to your regular walk. And noticing what it's like to walk like yourself. Noticing how your body feels different after a couple minutes of silly walking. And just back to regular walking. And so what this does is it sort of like a zones of regulation almost kind of practice in terms of really helping kids, you know, activate that symptom of silliness, right? Kids who struggle with being out of control, they get sillier and sillier and sillier, but then they learn how to practice going from 10% silly to more and then kind of all the way back down again to learn how to modulate their silliness rather than being all on or all off as they so oftentimes are. And so what we're teaching them is really how to do that. How to shift gears, how to go from totally silly to less silly, or even practicing going from 50% silly back down to zero. A lot of kids that we work with, particularly those with executive function difficulties and other kind of challenges, they're not very good at going from 100% down to zero. Kids often don't have an on-off switch. So what we're trying to do is teach them how to have more of a dimmer switch. Can you move from all the way silly back down to a little bit silly and a little bit back up again? They practice this with us in groups or in other kinds of situations, and ultimately then they can learn to do this on their own. In their classroom, when they're feeling a little bit silly, they can go back down to zero silly. Or when they're at home, they can go from being a little bit silly back down, or move at least from 100% silly down to 50% silly. And we do it in a way that's fun, that's a game, the kids enjoy. And so this is another one of my real favorite practices to be doing with kids. And the inspiration from this comes from a book called Taming a Wild Elephant.